What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Elementary Game Channel. I'm AJ Gels. Guys, we are back with L.A. Noir. I'll be doing another homicide case. The Golden Butterfly is up next. That's a funny sounding name.
Galloway. Got it, Skipper. Yeah, I'll bring him. He's my partner, after all.
What have we got?
New case. White female dumped in plain sight in the grass at the end of Hill Street. Hats are all over it. Captain's trying to fend him off.
That sounds awfully similar.
The first rule of police work is make no assumptions until you've seen the evidence. Skipper wants you to have your newspaper face on, college boy. I think I know the place where they found the lady. It overlooks Sunset Boulevard. Let's go.
Sunset Boulevard, fantastic musical, if you've never seen it. I would definitely suggest it. It's really, really good musical.
Mister, a man like you always loses a battle of wits. Because you're unarmed.
You know, I'm contemplating getting a new microphone. Maybe it'll fix this. I don't know, the sound problem that I'm having. Like, if you notice, like my voice audio sounds like there's kind of like a electric hum underneath everything
did
I say.
Did a decent job on the Henry case, Phelps. Not bad for your first time in bat.
Thanks, Rusty.
Don't go getting ahead of yourself. That's one clearance under your belt. Now it's a new day with a new dead lady that needs our attention.
No assumptions until we see the evidence, right?
Right. See, I knew you were a fast learner, Phelps. You might get along after all.
God damn it. What was I saying? Oh yeah, there's like that weird electric like... God damn it!
Whoa there!
Stupid other drivers. But yeah, there's like that weird kind of just... I don't know what to call it. I don't know if it's like feedback or what it is. Like, I don't know if it's my software or my microphone. Because I don't get it when I record on PS4 or Xbox One. I only get it when I record on PC, so I don't know. See, I'm thinking about getting a better mic and seeing if it'll fix the problem. Looking at getting a better mic anyways. I think I'm looking at a Turtle Beach... Twitch streaming microphone. You know, saw it. Looked interesting. You know, I trust Turtle Beach.
Now
good brand.
Boys, you know as much as I do. I'll be holding a press conference once the autopsy's been completed. I have two of my finest investigators on the case. Fresh from bringing down the sword of justice on the crazed sex...
Captain, aren't there similarities between this murder and the murder of Celine Henry? And of Elizabeth Short, for that matter.
So you don't believe there's a crazed sex killer at large preying on women?
Boys, be sensible. We have the greatest police force in all the world, with the greatest scientific investigators at our disposal. How can any killer continue to be that? Be advised. We keep the gas chamber at San Quentin primed for the sons of Cain who continue to believe they can take a life in the City of Angels.
Yeah, right. Any new leads in the Dahlia case?
Run along, boys, and let these officers get to work. We have God's work to do here, and it can't be delayed.
What do we have, Captain?
Another woman sacrificed. Speak to Carruthers. I want daily reports, gentlemen.
This is awful. Just awful.
Detective,
why can't we get
I was first
closer?
On scene.
You find her, Gonzalez?
Not me. Family out for a stroll. I was first reporting.
Can you show me the body?
It's under the pepper tree, this way.
How bad is it?
Come on, you can tell me.
God damn it,
can't
we
be much help to
put
you, Phelps.
Clothes on these women? Damn it, Rockstar.
Here she is.
The stomping angle in the Henry case, was it reported in the press?
Sure was. Every detail a copycat would want was there in the story.
Well, we have a name. Can you run Deirdre Muller by R&I?
Back in a second.
If the motive was robbery, why not take the money? Look at your marker. Very distinctive.
I'll do some comparisons back at the lab and get back to you.
What's this mark? Cut on a finger.
Fourth finger, left hand. A wedding or engagement ring. Violently removed.
Like she was tied up.
It does at first, but that would leave a mark on her other wrist, too. I think her watch might have been torn off.
Detective, that.
R&I says a Deirdre Mahler of 130 North Bonnie Bray was reported missing this morning by her husband, Hugo Mahler.
What'd I tell you? Just grab the husband, take him downtown, and work him over. We could have this wrapped up by lunchtime.
What about not making assumptions and going on the evidence?
Ugh. Again, can we please put clothes on the body? I don't want to get it. I don't know exactly what they'd do. But again, I'm always afraid that YouTube's going to do something. I don't know.
You know the way. You can drive.
There still might be some play in the boyfriend angle.
I thought we were on our way to lock up the husband.
If he doesn't work out, that is.
Deirdre Muller has suffered enough. More than enough. You shouldn't make disparaging comments about her without even the slightest inkling of what she was like.
She was a woman, wasn't she? Well, around about my third divorce, I realized women might not be the pure angels we imagine. You're married, ain't you, Phelps?
Don't make any insinuations about my wife.
Hey, she's a woman.
She's the mother of my children.
You're a father, Cole? Don't tell me your eye don't bend.
This conversation is over.
Oh, Rusty.
Phelps and Galloway, LAPD. Is your father home?
We'll be home soon. He's been out looking for mommy.
What's your name, miss?
Michelle Eloise Mahler.
Can we come in?
I suppose so.
Thank you. Could you have a seat for me, Michelle?
See, that's not safe, kids. Always make sure that they show you the badge.
We're going to have a look around.
Because, you know, somebody shows up at your house and says they're police, you don't just let them in. You know what I mean? Especially if they're like police plainclothes detectives.
This doesn't pertain to the case.
All right. Have it your way.
My partner will explain everything when we get back, okay? Don't worry about it.
Size 8. Elgin wristwatch. Probably the same one snatched from her body. No sign of a wedding ring.
Mommy, Daddy is trying to find her. Please tell me she's okay.
I'm sorry to have to tell you this, Michelle, but your mother is dead. Do you think you could answer a few questions for us?
Try.
When did you last see your mother?
Yesterday afternoon. I went to a dance at Belmont High. Mommy was supposed to pick me up, but she didn't show.
So what did you do then?
I was upset. Daddy came instead.
And did he come and get you?
Of course. Some boys offered me a ride home, but that's not the right thing to do.
So you were hanging around the school for quite a while. What happened with your father?
I don't know. I called and called and finally he answered. He came straight away then.
Some of your mother's jewelry was missing. Can you describe her things?
Ring, watch. I never paid much attention to that stuff.
Damn it!
I'm reluctant to talk about her jewelry.
It's a touchy subject with Daddy. He thought she wasted too much money on her appearance.
Thought she was making the same face as the first time.
Your mom and dad are happily married?
What are you saying? Of course they are.
They weren't happy, were they, Michelle? Did your father ever hit your mother?
Just the once. She said she would leave him if he ever did it again. He bought her a brooch pin to make up for it. And he always wore her golden butterfly.
I know this is a tough time for you, Michelle, but you should really try and help the police.
Hey! What gives?
Daddy, the police are here.
Go to your room, please, Michelle. I'll talk to the police.
Daddy, Mommy is gone.
Go to your room, young lady. She's not even out of school. You can't come in here interrogating her like she's some kind of...
Your wife was found murdered this morning.
Found? What? But she only...
We have some questions that we would like to ask you.
Sure, yeah. Yeah, I'll do my best.
What size shoe do you wear, Mr. Mueller?
Why do you ask?
It's routine, sir. Simple process of elimination.
Nines, I think.
Why are you lying to me, Mr. Mueller?
Why would I lie to you at a time like this?
That's funny. The work boots we found here are size 8s. Why lie about it if you've got nothing to hide?
Because I always get teased about the size of my feet. You know, small feet, small...
Always been true in my experience.
So you were here all night. You stayed in while your wife went out to pick up your daughter?
Yes, that's correct.
You should come clean if you're having an affair, or if there's something going on.
I told you I was here. Were you saying I wasn't?
So why did you take so long to answer the phone when your daughter called?
Okay, I went out for a while. I was driving around. It's my way of relaxing.
You phoned in a missing persons report this morning?
Yeah, that's right. My wife didn't come home last night. She left around 9:30. Michelle was out at dance. She called me to let me know that Deidre didn't turn up.
Did your wife ever go out by herself? To bars, nightclubs?
No. What are you suggesting? You suggesting my wife's loose? Now is not the time for you to be pushing me, mister.
Your daughter said you were having an argument.
We argued about who would pick up Michelle. I worked a full day. I wanted to come home, put my feet up.
Your wife went to pick up Michelle?
Yes, that's right.
What happened, Hugo? You got any theories? Because we're starting to like you for this.
The car park by the school is kind of dark. Maybe somebody jumped her there. Did you try the parking lot?
Your wife was beaten and then strangled. In your case, you have no alibi and a history of violence towards your wife.
That's not true, goddammit!
It is true, Hugo. You're a violent man. You try to keep a lid on it at home, but sometimes you lost control. Your daughter and your wife were scared of you.
You don't know anything about me.
I know about the golden butterfly, Hugo, and how you bought your wife off the last time you heard her.
She liked to spend money, all right? Dresses, jewelry, her hair, it drove me goddamn crazy. Do I look like a Rockefeller?
Nobody likes a cheapskate, Hugo.
Getting hostile with us is a very bad idea, Hugo.
I'm no murderer.
Make some arrangements for your daughter, and then present yourself to Central Station for questioning.
You gotta be kidding me, Phelps. Put the cuffs on him.
This is an outrage! I didn't kill my wife!
Your daughter is in the next room, Mueller, so I'm giving you a break. Don't make me change my mind, and don't make me come looking for you.
You should go back in there and bust his ass!
One, we need to break his alibi. Check phone records, canvass the neighbors. Two, we have motive of domestic violence, which probably goes for half the men in L.A. Three, we have no evidence tying him to the crime scene.
Hello, detective.
Okay, I don't think I've ever used that one. Yeah, okay, I've seen that one. I feel like changing it up. I just kind of like that.
Yes, ma'am.
I heard the terrible news over the radio.
And you can help us with our inquiries?
Yes, sir. They had a row last night. I heard Mrs. Mueller screaming.
Did you see Mrs. Mueller come home late last night at all?
No, not at all. I did see Mr. Mahler put something in the incinerator earlier this morning, though.
I told you he was our guy. Now let's get this bum downtown and into a cell.
Look, there he is now.
I gotta have it. Step away from the incinerator. Don't let him get away.
Okay, but no shooting. We need this guy to make the case.
This doesn't look good, Hugo.
I can explain the blood.
Come on, just like the last time, he just stepped in a cherry pie.
We'll be speaking with him later. And inform the captain.
Yes, sir, detective.
Is there someone you can call, miss?
I don't... Someone's home and...
You need somewhere to stay, Michelle. You have other family? Grandparents? Aunts or uncle?
Call Aunt Helen, but she lives in Acresfield and...
Call her. We're gonna get someone down here from Juvenile Hall to talk to you in the meantime.
You know what? I kind of liked... I liked it at first. No.
Let me get some uniforms down here and clean up. Take care of the kid.
I'm not feeling it anymore. I don't know. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go back to the Sword of Justice. Kind of like the dark blue.
Now I'm waiting tables.
Galloway, Homicide Division, Badge number 564.
Go ahead, Detective Unit.
Can we get Ray Pinker and a technical services team to a house at 130 North Bonnie Bray Street?
How can I help, Detective?
Send someone down for
I need an address on a Belmont High School.
Lady.
Checking for you, Detective. Belmont High, 1575 West 2nd Street.
Thanks.
Seems like a nice boy, putting all those hoodlums in jail.
Just gonna make sure there aren't any street crimes that I've missed. Oh, there's one. We'll go to the high school first.
Galloway, Homicide Division, Badge number 564.
Go ahead, Detective Unit.
Can we get Ray Pinker and a technical services team to a house at 130 North Bonnie Bray Street? And send someone down from Juvenile Hall to look after a young lady.
Roger, 11K. Inform Detective Phelps that the coroner has report waiting. Police board downtown when he's available. The most
got it, KGPL.
I'm surprised, you know. I didn't make the husband.
Always make the husband, Phelps. 9 times out of 10, it's the closest person to the Vic who does the deed. God knows I've wanted to force some lives in life.
Lex parsimonii.
What?
The law of parsimony. Occam's razor. The simplest explanation is most likely the correct one.
You know, you could have said that without getting all liturgical.
I'll try to dumb things down from now on.
Appreciate it. Try this one on our side. Rusty's razor.
How's that go?
You blame the guy that you're banging her.
Ah, of course. The famous Lex Ignoramus.
Close his cases, Cole. Puts a lot of people away that way.
I love Rusty.
Calling all cars. Citizen reports officer.
Isn't that a game? Calling all cars? I feel like it was. I know. I don't know. I've never gone and done the gone down the corner before the high school. So I don't know. Maybe we'll.
Any central unit of possible 288 at Belmont High School, 1575 West 2nd Street. Stand by for further unit to handle. Identify code 2.
11K to KGBL. We'll take the 288. Go ahead with the further.
I don't know where to go now. Now I remember why I'd go to the high school. I totally forgot about that guy.
Yeah.
Emmy. It's the first season since Fabergrashning's over. We have to go.
I told you, I can't Saturday. I'm busy.
Busy where? You're going on another drive with Davy Gardner, aren't you?
So what if I am?
Go, Belts. I'll take the car and see if I can cut him off.
Ha! Really short hurdles.
Go ahead.
11K, see the janitor. A green 1946 coupe registered to a Mrs. Hugo Moeller has been found in the parking lot adjoining the Belmont High School and playing field. 11K, code 2.
What's your name?
Who's asking?
We can do this the easy way or the hard way.
Name's Eli Rooney.
You've been in trouble with the law before, Eli?
Some.
What are you doing around here?
I like to keep an eye on the children.
Strictly paternal, is it, Eli?
Don't sass me, boy.
A woman was abducted here last night, Eli, and murdered.
And I would love to make you for that, you oaky motherfucker.
Well, I wouldn't know nothing about that. A woman, you say? I like them a little younger than that.
Turn out your pockets, Eli.
Now, why would I do that?
Because I'm about to break your fucking skull, Eli.
You're under arrest, Eli. You're in very deep trouble. Get some backup down here, Rusty. We need to get this one downtown and into a cell.
I'll tell them we got a kitty raper coming in. They can roll out the red carpet.
What time did you see the person park the car?
Late last night, after school social, maybe 1 a.m. I've been keeping a good eye out lately. We've had problems with the child molester.
Eli Rooney. We've met him.
Filthy son of a bitch. He was here yesterday before the dance.
Was it him you saw park the car?
I don't know, sir. I'd like to say yes, but the truth is it was pretty dark.
Would you say Rooney is violent?
Yes, sir. I would say so, yes.
Thanks for your help. Blood and skin samples. We better get Ray Pinker out here.
It's from a Chrysler. Could be important.
The overalls are stenciled HM. Muller is a mechanic. I wonder what Eli does for a living.
Yeah, before I hit Central, I'm gonna go back and just lost my train of thought. Oh yeah, I'm gonna do that street crime. I'm gonna make sure I get it pinged. Then we'll have a rusty door driving.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need interrogation set up at Central for both suspects being held in the Mahler homicide case.
Certainly, Detective. I'll get in touch with the watch commander.
Thank you. You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
Bullseye is right on the money.
Calling all cars. Citizen reports officer needs help. Shots fired. Officer down. 6th Street and Lindley Place. 6th Street and Lindley Place. Unit to handle code 3. Identified.
This is car 11K. We're on the help call.
Alleyway leads to the rear of the building, sir. Someone's gonna have to climb up and take him down.
Good luck. Don't let him get a bead on you like I did.
Cop killers are the worst kind of stuff.
Guy. I heard he's an honest
first aid
cop.
Kid.
What? No, I don't want to drive.
Can you drive to this one?
That's as refreshing as it is.
I say we make Rooney for this. I think we should lay it on him. He was near the car, he had her jewelry, the DA will love him for it.
Even if he didn't do it?
Who cares whether he did it? You have kids, Phelps? He needs to be taken permanently out of harm's way.
And we let Mueller slide?
For a while. He gets a free pass from me.
Phelps, Rusty, thanks for coming.
Can you blood type the shoes that we bagged and see if they're a match?
Sure. It'll all be in the report, but I'm assuming you want the details now?
Please. Cause of death is strangulation?
Correct. Take a look at the samples on the bench.
What are the normal uses for that kind of rope?
On boats, mooring lines.
Correct. Although Ray says that they're sometimes used as bell ropes in churches.
So are we looking for a sailor or a minister?
Well, in my experience, sailors seem to have the greater libido.
Was Mrs. Mueller criminally attacked?
No external or internal traces of semen.
Thanks, Mal. Anything else comes up, you let us know.
Yeah, that's a weird word to say. I don't know why. So, I don't know. It's one of those words that hits the ears and makes you go, ugh.
You're behind the wheel.
Hit it, Rusty.
Not exactly the happiest of places, the coroner's office.
Carruthers is a good man, professional, diligent. If you're working with a pro, it's easy to overlook the grim realities of a place like that.
Funny job, that, the coroner's.
How so?
Well, you don't want them enjoying their work too much. The wrong kind of man can get awful lonely rattling around a joint full of corpses.
Rusty, that's like something out of the pulps.
Been reading the same ones as me?
I thought you were usually too drunk to get through a magazine.
You know, if I close one eye and squint, you can just about make out the print.
All right, let's put this one away, guys.
Better not go soft on me in here, Phelps.
We'll work the evidence, Rusty. Let him do the rest.
Yeah, I want to make homicide. You know you've got it made if you can get to that desk.
Here's where we stand, Hugo. Your next-door neighbor heard screaming coming from your house. You were burning your blood-stained shoes. You have no one who can confirm your whereabouts last night. Your daughter says you're a violent man. We have everything we need to send you to death row, and all you have to say for yourself is, I didn't do it.
I swear I didn't kill her. Give me that lie test. I can prove it.
Why did you burn your shoes, Hugo?
Because I knew you'd never believe me.
Are you going to tell me what I want to know, or do we have to take it out of you in lumps?
Give it your best shot. I can take whatever you're throwing.
Do you know anything about ropes, Hugo?
As much as the next man. I was a scout. I learned some more in the army.
You know anything about braided ropes?
Some. They're mainly used for mooring lines, hawsers. You know, that kind of stuff. We don't have much use for them in the machine shop. We use chain hoists.
Man, over two.
Your wife was beaten with a tire iron, Hugo. An appropriate choice of tool for a mechanic.
I know nothing about any tire iron.
Yeah, it's not a truth, but I don't think I have anything to...
You're going to die for this, Mueller. Better give me something if I'm going to believe your story.
My conscience is clear. You can't badger me into admitting anything.
Jeez.
We found your wife's car. Someone parked it at the school late last night. Do you have anything to say about that?
It wasn't me.
Where do you keep your work clothes?
I keep them at work in my locker.
Enough lies, Hugo. Your overalls put you at the scene of the crime last night.
My overalls are in the laundry of my house.
Green overalls, bloodstained, with the initials HM found in the trunk of your wife's car.
They can't be mine.
Why, Hugo? Because if they were yours, they'd be in the incinerator too?
Some kind of trouble?
For interrogation two, or interrogation one, I think it is.
Captain, we were on our way to interview Eli Rooney.
Yes, Phelps, I know. This particular fiend is an old acquaintance.
I have tried to reaffirm his belief in a wrathful and terrible God. Whichever way it goes, I'll be dealing personally with him.
All right.
You look like you've had it rough.
You see me asking for your sympathy, boy?
You're down on your luck, Eli.
I had worse. My family ate roadkill during the Dust Bowl.
But you have a job. A parolee has to have a job, correct?
I had me a job down in San Pedro. I'm looking for something new.
This place you worked have a name?
Hennessy Marine. You can't miss the place. Big yellow letters HM out front.
They give you any workwear, Eli?
Sure. Green coverall. Dang thing was hot. Felt like I was back in the pen wearing it.
You ever tie up any of your victims, Eli?
It's not a nice thing to go calling them.
What would you call them?
I can't say. I learned a long time ago not to go talking about the things I like. Talking about it just seems to get people's dander up.
Answer the goddamn question, Rooney, before I brain you.
See what I mean? Short answer is yes.
You have any preference regarding rope, Eli?
I know a good rope from a bad rope, if that's what you mean. That's not what you mean, is it? Any old rope will do me fine.
A blonde boy like you, Eli, must prefer McGay for roping, am I right?
I prefer braid, tie, hitch, and braid. It stays tied.
You killed Mrs. Muller and stole her jewelry.
That ain't so. I ain't done nothing like that.
You're a liar, Eli. You needed the money, so you killed her.
I've been around some, son. You got some evidence that proves I stole that butterfly from that woman?
It was in your freaking pocket.
I done told you I found that pretty thing. I never stole it.
I don't like you, Eli. I think you're an evil man. I think you try to pass off your pain to other people. I can't make you for this case, but my consolation is that I don't think you will be out of prison for very long.
You can count on it, shitbird. By the way, Eli, the captain and the hat squad would like to talk to you next. Any idea what they might want to talk about?
That's the guy. Detective, that's him. That's the guy who parked the car, I'm sure of it. Hey, just get in the way!
That's not true. I can't go to jail.
Huh. You know, it's weird. I've never had this happen.
You gotta get me closer. Hit it.
Oh, Christmas.
Get this asshole off the road. I'm trying to shoot out his tire. Wish me luck. Hit him, Cole. Spin him out.
Ben's here, Hugo. Once we get the janitor's statement, you'll be staring down a murder charge.
I have to say I'm disappointed. I stood in front of a troop of reporters and made promises. Promises of swift and fearful retribution, and you bring me an armful of vagrant happenstance. You made the department look bad, lad. Do it again and your career as a policeman will come to an abrupt and ignominious end. You two are back on the streets. Find street criminals, roust them, beat them, and restore some fervor to your police work. Your next case will come when you've revived my faith in your abilities. Now get out of here!
Okay, I mean, we had a witness putting him at this. Yeah, whatever. I don't think I've ever gotten that ending either, man. That's weird. I got a one. Oh, man, I suck.
Two regular armies.
Lieutenant!
Belt, we've been over this. That sniper barely missed you back on the beach. Until the mission is over, there'll be no more saluting or signs of rank.
I'm in charge here, Metier!
Do you wish to interrogate the prisoners?
I know they're beat. Why they look so sullen. You're wondering why we haven't killed them yet. There is no greater shame than being taken prisoner.
Get this, Golden Boy actually seems to know what he's doing.
Not got to know, Kai Soto.
See that, boys? He slapped that Jap right upside the head.
It was merely to remind him of his place. His shame was the tone of voice that he used with a superior. I respect the Japanese, Corporal.
Respect? We're here to kill the sons of bitches.
Do you know why we're fighting the Japanese, Private?
With respect, sir, these bastards attacked Pearl Harbor.
And why did they attack Pearl, Private?
Because they hate the U.S. of A and our way of life.
They attacked the U.S. because we cut off their oil. What would we do if another country denied us the gas to run our cars?
Well, there's the name of our next case. We will be doing that, obviously, as I said, next time. So thanks for watching, guys, and until then, remember to find me on Facebook, Twitter, the website down in the description below, and remember to like, comment, and if you're not already, please subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more. But until then, I'm AJ Gels, see you on the Thar Gaming Channel, I'm out.